quick video to say that Canva has finally listened. We can have gradient text when we are creating. And let's quickly see, when can you use this gradient text? You can use them for your animations. You can use them for your ads, for your social media, on your page, on your business page.
That's what I'm talking about.
Gradient is a beautiful way to bring designs to life. So let me quickly show you how you use this app that Canva has integrated to our apps on Canva. Let's jump right in. There's two ways that you can find the app. From your home page, you can go to your apps and you can search for type gradient. The other way is if you're already on a design, you can scroll down to your apps and you can search for type gradient over there and you can pick up the app this way. And when you double click on the app, you install it as one of your apps, it will be available there. So how does it work? It comes up with the place where you can add your text, the place where you can change your font, the alignment, the line height, the gradient, and how it looks like. And then when you are adding it or if you're resetting the position. It's very similar to TimeCraft that we've been working on making lovely logos on Canva. So say for example, you wanna use it for a design for a pink sail like we just did. You just type your text where it says main text and then you scroll down to go pick your font on the list of fonts that are available there. It does show you how the font looks like, which I really, really quite like. Or you could search for the font if you already know the name of the font that you're looking for. So I'm happy with the Anton font. You're gonna click on the back button. It will pick the font that you selected. And when you scroll down, you're able to align the text that you've added on at the bottom. So when you click on alignment, if the font was a little bit smaller, then it would align to the middle or it would align to the left hand side. So this font that I've chosen is quite big. That's why the alignment is not moving on the preview. So that's how you look and you view what you're busy designing. That works exactly as the line height as well. It works like the line height that we use when we're designing on Canva, but how you can view it is this way. And when you scroll down, this is where you choose the gradient colors as well as how the gradient should look like. It does tell you a little small print that says, click anywhere to add a stop. So you could add a stop, you could also delete a stop so that it creates the gradient that you want at the bottom of the page. So let's pick this gradient, for example. If we don't want this gradient that automatically came with the app, you can select delete, and then you're left with two stops. If you want to add another stop, like it says, add a stop, you just click and it adds a stop. That's where you could also add a hex code or pick a color that you want to add on your design. And if you're happy, you can just click outside to see how the color looks like. And if you want to change the color, you can move the colors like that to pick the color that you want for your design. So let me select that again. Let's pick red and then add another stop. And when you click on the design itself, it adds different colors. On the preview section of the preview space, there are points that you can use to change and maneuver and make the gradient exactly the way that you want. So you can move around these points so that you can tweak. As you can see, when I move these points, the gradient gets adjusted to the way that I want. So you could move it exactly to where you want the pink to start, where the pink should end, and exactly the way that you want. So it's quite a nice tool to have. If you want to start from fresh, you can just reset the position and it's sitting where it was, and you can adjust and then you can add this to the design. And then your design is added to your ad and you can tweak it that way that you like. If you've added your gradient text to the design and you decide, oh, I want to change it, you can select the text and click on edit. It will open up type gradient again, and then you can start editing it the way that you want and adjusting it, just like we did now with our video. Text is added on a design. Canva sees this as an image, so it has selected it as an image, so you can edit it like a text. You can adjust the border style though and make it smaller. You can make the corner rounding of your design, because Canva sees this as an image instead of text. If you want to make changes, you need to go back to edit, then scroll up to go change whatever you want to change. If you want to change it on the text, you just go to text and you change it there, and then you scroll down to the bottom of the page and you say update element, and then it gets updated. And that's how it works. Quite cool. Let me know in the comments if you're excited about this app. The next video that you could watch is when we were designing a logo using Typecraft on Canva. Thank you for joining me. I will see you on our next video.